So I've got my kneeling pad, my favouritest of all snowdrop transplanting tools, and I've dug up two different kinds of snowdrops. This is a late flowering one here. Most of these are this late flowering small one, and then there's this one, whoops, that I'm told is just a cross-pollinated. It's not a specific kind, but you could say it's our one because it was probably a cross-pollination that occurred, and I've slowly been spreading these all around. So none of these are bought-in ones. They're literally ones. This one would be one that my grandfather planted, and I'm not planting these early ones yet in this area. So this is gonna be my Sunday morning. There's easily several hundred snowdrop bulbs in that. So I'm gonna go up here to this area, bypassing that clump, which I'm going to have to divide because they're getting less and less flowers, which means they're feeling cramped, and go up here into this wooded area that I was showing you earlier. You can see all the wood anemone are going to be coming up, wonderful blue ones. Here are some snowdrops that I did. Over here are more snowdrops that I did, and here are a few more. So I'm gonna start all the way up here and work backwards on my cushion, trying to avoid squishing too many of the jack in the pulpits. You can see they're coming up there. So this is where the sheep are in the orchard, and I'm gonna start sowing my snowdrops in this area. Oh, look! Look at this beautiful, look at those. Where are the beautiful cup mushrooms? Look at that. So gorgeous. Here's one, oop, oh, and a snail. And there's more of that. Anyway, that is where I'm gonna be. And the winds are gonna pick up. The winds are picking up. So, oh, there's loads of these. Oh, look! Look, 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 look. Loads of them. Aren't they lovely? They're so beautiful.